This week's episode is another popular request from the comments section. The basics on TITANS. TITAN is a word that's come into use only recently to describe a concept that's existed for a lot longer. Huge transformers so large, they turn into entire cities. Or at least that's what the marketing says they turn into. In practice, their alternate modes are normally depicted as being large fortresses composed of a few buildings at best, but let's not get distracted by semantics. For years, the best names we've had for this kind of robot were self-explanatory fan-created ones like Cityformers or Citybots. More obscure media has tried on the name Megamaster, but TITAN has emerged out of IDW Publishing's comic books in the last few years and been quickly embraced by Hasbro, who have used it in various capacities, including in the name of the 2016 TITANS Return toy line. So, how did we get here? The first Cityformer was the Autobot Metroplex, a toy originally designed for the Japanese Diaclone line. Its Diaclone release was cancelled, but Hasbro acquired the design and released the figure in the Transformers line in 1986. To serve as Metroplex's rival on the Decepticon side, a Decepticon City was also released that same year, the Dinosaur Tripticon. The Generation 1 cartoon detailed the pair's creation on Earth and showcased several memorable battles between them in its third season. Famously, Metroplex functioned as a subsection of the larger Autobot City, the Autobot stronghold on Earth, introduced in the Transformers the movie. Two further Citybot toys arrived in 1987, the Decepticon Headmaster Leader Scorponok and the colossal Autobot Headmaster Leader Fortress Maximus, who, at 22 inches in height, held the record as the tallest Transformers toy for over 25 years. However, the fictional portrayals of these two characters didn't really emphasize them as cities. Cartoons treated their alternate modes more like huge starships, while the Marvel comic threw out the idea of them being gigantic entirely, presenting them instead as being normal-sized Transformers, only a little taller than the average bot. This established the pattern that modern comic book depictions of the characters have tended to follow. Metroplex and Tripticon are giants, but Fortress Maximus and Scorponok are regular size, reimagined with non-city alternate modes. These four were it for Citybots from Hasbro, but others were created for the Japanese market by recoloring the existing toys to make new characters. Fortress Maximus was recolored to create Grand Maximus in 1988's Super God Master Force, and Brave Maximus in 2000's Car Robots, while Metroplex was recolored as the Decepticon city Metro Titan in 1990's Transformers Zone. Another Metroplex recolor named Metro Base featured in 2003's Transformers Micromaster, but he didn't have a toy, appearing only in artwork. There were other characters with battle station or base modes, but none of them even began to approximate the scale that these giants operated on. Of course, that said, in the real world, it was fundamentally impossible for Citybot toys to actually be in scale with other Transformer toys in any realistic way. No toy could be that big. At best, they were sized to interact with the smallest figures in the series, who could roll down their ramps and fit in their bays, and each came packaged with one or more unique partner figures. In the 21st century, relative scale between figures became more of a concern than it had been in the Generation 1 years, so Cityformers decreased in plausibility as toys, meaning the concept didn't get much play in the various new series and continuities introduced in the 2000s. Metroplex, Fortress Maximus, and Tripticon did show up in Transformers Animated towards the end of the decade, but only as non-transforming buildings with no implication that they were alive or had robot modes. While Tripticon appeared in the War for Cybertron video game, but as a space station. It was in 2012 that the Citybot concept was revived, starting again with Metroplex, who returned to the spotlight in multiple different continuities simultaneously. In the summer of that year, a new origin for the character was introduced, first in IDW Publishing's Transformers Autocracy comic book, and soon after in the Fall of Cybertron video game, which presented him not as having been built on Earth as in Generation 1, but as an ancient Transformer who had been slumbering on Cybertron in city mode for eons until awakened by Optimus Prime and the Matrix to aid the Autobots in their war. IDW quickly built on their version of this story to reveal that Metroplex was just one of an entire race of ancient city Transformers who were collectively known as Titans. The name was evidently cribbed from Metro Titan, and fittingly enough, he was among the other Titans glimpsed in the story that introduced the concept. As you can see, in this introductory story, all the Titans looked like differently coloured Metroplexes, not unlike how CityBot toys were often recolors of one another. But over the next few years, IDW would develop the mythology of the Titans into one of the major underpinning concepts of their comic book universe, introducing many new comic original Titan characters with their own unique designs. Where Generation 1's CityBots had been very large but otherwise normal robots, IDW's Titans were vast, unknowable beings who held many secrets, who had allegedly existed since near the dawn of Cybertron itself and had become intertwined with the planet's many myths and legends. They had supposedly served Primus and the other gods of Cybertron, the mythical first generation of Transformers known as the Knights of Cybertron, and the fabled 13 Primes. Using their built-in space bridges to traverse the cosmos, the Titans served as living starships for their masters, with many carrying new Cybertronian life across the universe to colonize other planets. Once settling on these worlds, the Titans would sleep in their city forms, in which state they could only be communicated with via the art of city speaking, a talent that allowed its practitioners to interpret the patterns of light that race across a Titan's gigantic brain module. Some of the more notable Titans from IDW's stories have included Caminus, the Titan of Solus Prime, on whose colony City Speaking originated, Chella, the bird-like Titan of Onyx Prime, who colonized the beast world of Eucharis, and the evil Vigilam, the Titan of Liege Maximo, who turned on his brethren but was defeated and forced to serve as a living prison for his wicked master. Metro Titan was found on Earth and fell under Optimus Prime's command to become IDW's version of Autobot City, and even Metroplex's eternal rival Trypticon was introduced as a formerly evil Titan, now reformed and serving as the Earth Embassy on Cybertron. Hasbro were quick to jump on the Titan concept, releasing a huge new Metroplex figure as part of the Transformers Generations toy line in 2013, complete with a profile that described his new backstory as an incredibly ancient Transformer. The figure was so big that it dethroned Fortress Maximus as the tallest Transformer toy, and the new price point it was sold at was dubbed the Titan size class. Hasbro went on to put the Titans front and center in 2016 when they debuted the Titans Return toy line, which included Titan class figures of Fortress Maximus, allowing him to retake his title from Metroplex, and Trypticon, and introduced the idea of Titan Masters, tiny Transformers who crewed and controlled the giants. Both the promotional material for the toy line and Machinima's tie-in Titans Return cartoon closely adapted IDW's story of the Titans, depicting them as ancient Transformers from the dawn of time whose purpose was to travel the universe sowing other planets with Cybertronian life. The cartoon also featured city speaking, reimagined as more straightforward telepathy, and furthermore, married the Titan origin story with more traditional Generation 1 depictions of CityBots by presenting Metroplex as one of these ancient robots, but Fortress Maximus as having been built during the Autobot-Decepticon War, expanding the definition of Titan to encompass CityBots in general, not just the ancient race with whom the name originated. These ideas even fed back into Japanese media a little. After the new Metroplex toy was released in Japan, between 2013 and 2018, the Metro Wars and Transformers Legends manga, which were set within the timeline of the Generation 1 cartoon, explained that Metroplex was just the newest member of an ancient clan of Metro-type Transformers to which the older Metro Titan and Metro Base both belonged, echoing the Titan concept, though not using the name. Metrobase was even given a new purple color scheme inspired by one of the generic Titans who had appeared in IDW's comics to further tie the ideas together. While IDW's comics may soon be coming to an end, given the way it's quickly spread outside them to toys and cartoons all around the world, it feels like Titan is gonna stick around as a term for the foreseeable future. And those are the basics on Titans. Tell me about your favorite city former in the comments. I might do an episode about them. In the meantime, remember to like, share, and subscribe, and visit Patreon to support the show.